At first, it seemed just like old times. The gang was back in action. But little by little, we learned that Murray's heart just wasn't in it. Without the guru's permission to give up on his Dreamtime training, he'd never really feel comfortable returning to the gang. We knew we needed to help him out. So, we packed up our things, whipped up some quick disguises, and headed for the Australian Outback. Along the way, Murray told us story after story about his teacher's amazing abilities. Apparently, this guru of his was capable of fantastic feats. He used the Dreamtime to blend perfectly into his surroundings and even gain mental control over the weak-minded. If even half the stories were true, then this was a guy I just had to meet. Our gang needed to grow its ranks for a chance to get inside the Cooper Vault. And this guru, this Outback mystic, was looking like the best recruit we could have ever asked for. However, when we finally arrived in the Outback, it was a shock to find that things had changed. And the guru was nowhere to be seen.
Your power moves. The first one is throwing stuff.
Pluck it and chuck it. That's me.
To pick something up, just get close and hit the circle button. To throw, just face your target and press the square button.
Circle, square, ain't hardly fair. Looks like I've got plenty of rocks to throw with.
Try breaking all those pillars.
Can do.
You can also pick up guards when they're knocked out.
Great! I knocked the small guys out with one punch!
You might have to be a little more subtle with the big flashlight guards. They're pretty tough. Sneak up behind this guy and sucker punch him while he's not looking. Then pick him up and throw him at the pillar.
Gotcha! Sneak up, sucker punch, grab, throw, destroy! Kid stuff.
Let's see what you got. Way to knock out guards is to throw something at them.
Ah, the old rock to the head routine.
Yep, throw a rock at that guard to knock him out, then pick him up and throw him at that pillar.
Can do, little brother.
Grab him while he's out.
Thank you.
what's different about this next guy?
He's got a ton of cash in his back pocket. Chump, he's just asking, begging me to rob him.
That's right. You may not have the agility or technology to pick his pocket, but you could use your strength to mug him quite thoroughly.
Oh, yeah. I just knock him flat, then pick him up.
Once you've got him above your head, press the circle button to shake loose any coins he has and collect the goods. Keep at it until he's empty.
The Murray will give this high roller a shakedown he'll never forget.
The juggle grab is one of your most powerful moves. You ready?
Born ready!
When facing off against smaller opponents, you can knock them into the air with your triangle button uppercut, and then grab them before they hit the ground by pressing the circle button.
Okay. Let me see if I've got it. Hit them with my triangle button uppercut, then yank them out of the air by pressing the circle button. That right?
You got it. For this test, you'll have to pull it off 3 times and throw the guards at that pillar over there. Don't waste your time trying to fight them. Just focus on the technique.
Bring on the pain! From above.
Just jump and press the square button to break this ground plate a few times. I gotta hand it to you, Murray. You're ready to take on the world. We're done in here. Head outside and crack some skulls. The miners have really tore this place up looking for opals. Watch your step, they're sure to get rough defending their claim.
spends most of his time up there in that cave, overlooking the valley and contemplating the depths of deepness. I really appreciate you breaking the news to him that I want to break off my training.
No problem, pal. I'm looking forward to meeting him. Anybody you call Master must be a heck of a guy.
Oh, he's awesome! He'll get inside your head and freak you out 6 ways from Sunday.
Awesome. Sorry, pal. This cave's empty. Got any other ideas where he might be?
Well, that's his hut. But he doesn't really hang out there on account of the smell.
The smell?
It's a long story. I had to apologize up and down for like a month before he'd speak to me again.
What did you do?
The unspeakable, Sly. The unspeakable.
Well, thanks for speaking of it. I'm headed for the hut. Sorry, Murray. Nobody's home. And by the looks of it, I'd say the guru is fighting someone or something off here. I'm starting to think the miners might have got to him.
You might be right. They'd come in and be all angry and yelling, and he'd be all peaceful, and they'd just get ticked. Then he'd try to find a middle way, and they'd just go crazy and smash everything up, and then haul him off.
Where do you think they might have taken him?
They got him! My master's a goner!
Maybe we should get Bentley on the line.
It's tough to say, but given the layout of the miners' camp, I'd venture a guess that they used that area with a high fence as a makeshift stockade.
Looks like there might be a way up using that cliff below. Shouldn't be a problem.
Just keep an eye out for that gyrocopter. I'm positive it's what gave away the guru's position.
Good tip. Thanks, pal. Thank you.
have no respect for the Aboriginal sacred site. They're drilling into everything. Ayers Rock, Kings Canyon, Wave Rock. The cultural insensitivity is sickening.
You must be the guru. I'm a good friend of Murray's. He's come asking to be released from his training. Sure, I'll just bust you out of here and we'll go talk to him.
Hi, how are you doing, Father?
You seriously won't leave without your gear? Yeah, I can see that the miners have really done a number on your land here. As for your walking staff and moonstone, me and my gang have a real talent for stealing back things that were wrongfully taken.
The guru won't leave the stockade until he has his walking staff and his moonstone. He also insists that we purify Ayers Rock of all miners. Only then will the Dreamtime spirits be appeased, and the guru will be free to use his powers. Sly must have impressed him in their conversation, because now he is requesting that Murray and I meet with him individually. Something about judging our spiritual centers. I've discovered a passage through one of the miners' caves that should make getting up to the guru less difficult. He also mentioned that the miners had foolishly unearthed the Mask of Dark Earth. I guess it was his job to guard the thing, and now that it's out, bad things are sure to follow. Sounds like mumbo jumbo to me, but we've encountered some unexplainable phenomena over the years, so I'm not gonna rule it out as a threat to our operation.
humbug.
Again, but he's requested that you and I pay him a visit individually.
If it wasn't for the guru, I wouldn't be the Murray you see before you today. I'm just not too sure he'll be pleased with my progress as a mystic.
What are you talking about? You used the aboriginal ball form to great effect back in Venice. He'll be proud of you.
Maybe, but I lost my temper and got in a fight with Octavio.
To help me? I'm sure the guru is happy to see friends sticking up for each other. Head into this cave. It'll take you right up to him.
Okay, Bentley. Caves ahoy!
According to the mine's hydraulic flow chart, the door ahead appears to be sealed shut.
Then I'll just bash it in! What's the good of having fists if you can't smack steel doors with them?
It's too thick, even for you. No, to get through, we'll have to overload the pressure in this piston.
You want me to punch it? I could do that!
Use your aboriginal ball form to bounce on top of the piston and smash it down! Build up enough hydraulic pressure, and the door is sure to open.
Piston, beware! You're about to be bounced!
Thank you.
Eat it, piston sucker!
Another locked door. To open this one, you'll need to overload all three pistons at the same time.
Thank you.
I did it! 3 against 1, and I still took you piston chumps to school! Whoa! Look at the size of that guy! He must be jacked up by that mask of Dark Earth the Guru was warning us about!
Curious, it seems to make the wearer much larger. Probably more aggressive, too.
I can take him! My righteous quest to see the Guru won't be stopped by some big stupid freak in a mask!
Even if you won, you'd have nowhere to go. The door through has an electric deadbolt. This whole area runs off the same circuit. Even the drills are linked up.
Then I'll throw this clown into the drills!
That might break the circuit. Give it a try. Keep it up! You did some damage! One drill down, 2 to go! Just one left!
Holy cow! That mask can run! Mine can't do that!
Intriguing. Press on to the Guru. He'll have some answers. The door should be unlocked now that the drill circuit is broken.
Open up! I have returned, my master. The black water now runs clear. I'd like to... I am asking... Oh, man. Yeah! I want to join back up with my friends, and, we're hoping you'd come along, too?
Babaji?
You'd love it in the gang. We have all kinds of fun. Miners, gyrocopters... And a mask of Dark Earth? Yeah, that's a lot to deal with. But we'll help you, I promise!
Ooh-da-da.
Thanks, Guru. I'm happy to see you, too.
Murray, let's motor out to Ayers Rock and scare away those mining dingoes. Your Guru wants it purified.
Awesome! This is the biggest truck I've ever gotten to drive! I could crush houses with this baby!
Okay, Bentley. You've got my interest. Though it looks like I may have to take care of a few guards if I'm gonna get at those drill controls.
Defeat the guards and start the drill. Then Murray can begin phase 2 of my plan.
Ooh. Ooh.
work, Sly. The sonic vibrations caused by that drill should drive the giant scorpions in the area to the surface. If we can capture a bunch of red soldier scorpions, releasing them into Ayers Rock is sure to push out the miners.
Sounds like a job for the Murray. One question, though. How do I capture scorpions with a truck?
The vehicle is equipped with a supercharged e-brake, which, if pulled when moving, will cause a forward flip. Time it correctly, and you'll trap a scorpion in the mining that's built into the bed of the truck.
Okay, Bentley, bring on the scorpions!
Not so fast. The truck's tires will heat up quickly in this blazing hot sand. You'll have to cool them down by driving into the water or running over scorpions. Watch your heat meter to make sure they don't melt. And remember, we're only interested in the red soldier scorpions. The blue worker scorpions won't help us scare the miners off. The truck controls are straightforward. Hold the X button to go forward and the square button to drive in reverse. When you are going fast enough, press the up. You'll need to trap those red scorpions, Murray. Use the R1 button after you've built up some speed. Nice work. Looks like more are being driven to the surface.
Here we go! Whoa! Cha-ching!
Okay, Bentley, I'm on my way.
Got the hang of it now! Huh? Tumble! Uh-huh!
Don't bother trapping the blue ones. They're only good to cool down your tires.
Here we go! That's it! You're mine! Thank you.
we go!
Run for it, mate! Uh-oh!
Nice teamwork, guys. Ayer's rock is clean of miners. The Guru will be pleased. After capturing the guru, the dingoes confiscated his magic walking staff and moonstone. Without these objects, the guru is powerless.
Given that we're dealing with miners, I bet they stashed the goods in one of the caves around here. It's a secure location with plenty of guys on duty to provide protection.
I agree. The most likely candidate is this mineshaft. It appears to have the highest number of workers coming in and out.
Good place to start. I'm on it.
Those caves are gonna be dark. Your optimizer goggles will make navigation easier. If they're here, the guru's items would be stashed at the far end of this cave. The environment or anything, but these caves are rich with opals. I can see why these miners are so driven.
Time to take you back to your rightful owner. These miners are smarter than they look. They booby-trapped the moonstone. Looks like a light-sensitive detonator. If I can get it outside and into the sunlight, it should power down. Thank you.
The Guru's walking staff must be headed in their other cave complex. I've marked the entrance in your binoculars.
I wonder what's so special about this staff. Another booby trap for a stick? These guys are paranoid. And from the sound of it, they've called in reinforcements. Nothing like a horde of angry dingoes to make things a bit more interesting.
Oh, my God.
Of the stone. Murray has purified Ayer's rock, and now I humbly deliver your walking stick and moonstone. The time for escape has come.
Ooh-da-da.
Thank you, you're too kind. But tell me, how do you plan to escape?
Ooh-da-da-da.
Gadzooks! You can transform yourself. Why, once you change shape, a guard is sure to come inside and investigate!
Hey, Vavahonda! Hi, Vavahonda!
Too true! Wait, here comes a guard!
Master, hold down the L1 button to transform! I love it!
What? Where'd he go?
Master, you're the greatest! That jump's totally fooled! Once he's back, ram him into the cell door! Freedom! Oh, awesomeness! Let's show these miners who's boss. Head for the drills. I guess Bentley's found a weak spot.
I hear you. Those drills are tearing up the landscape. They appear to be fragile at the base. ram a guard into it, and the whole apparatus should break apart.
Harvard, I did hear you.
Oh yeah, some things never change. I know, it's awful. However, the Lynx generator is weak, easily destroyed, provided you can jump a few guards over there and ram it.
Hold on tight.
Oh.
You're the master! Master!
What the?
That machine is crying hot, oily tears from your righteous blow!
The Guru has agreed to join our team, provided we can rid his homeland of the Dingo Miners and deal with the Mask of Dark Earth. A tall order, but we're up for it. First, we'll enlist the aid of some local wildlife to help thin out the Miners' ranks. Murray will feed our foes to a local giant crocodile. With some luck, he'll take a liking to the taste of Miners and chow down on them left and right. Second, we'll hit these guys where they live, or at least relax. If we can clear them out of this lemonade bar, it'll be a crippling blow to their morale. They'll be begging to go home. And finally, Sly will use some mining equipment to drill for radioactive oil deep beneath the dried lake bed. Trust me, it's the key to getting rid of the Mask of Dark Earth.
We subtracted a few miners from the equation.
You know I don't understand that math talk.
We need to put the smackdown on these bad dudes for justice.
Righteous! I'm the man for the job!
The Guru will start luring miners to a position near this giant crocodile. Your job is to throw the thugs into the mouth of the monster.
Teach him to like eating miners, huh? That's a sinister plan, Bentley. I approve.
With some luck, the oversized reptile will be an invaluable asset in our efforts to drive away the miners. He might even take care of our Mask of Dark Earth problems. I've spotted it prowling near the safe house.
Roger, it's feeding time.
Hi-ya-di.
Both types of guards. Four kangaroos and four dingoes should do it.
You like that, huh?
Oh,
chomp that clown in half! Remember to chew! Tastes good. Chew that miner like bubblegum! Oh yeah, that's tasty! Snack time!
Give him a taste for both types of guards. Four kangaroos and four dingoes should do it.
Take a bite of this! Feeding time! Miner flavored miner! Yummy! Later, sucker! Eat up, pal! Later, sucker!
Great job, Murray. Now, feed the croc one last thing. A big, tasty flashlight guard. I've located one and marked it with a waypoint. Remember, you'll need to sneak up on this guy in order to grab him. Up on the miner with a flashlight in order to grab him.
Woo!
your hard work with this croc pays off. Tarnation, that mask keeps getting away. Since when do masks get away?
All right, boys. Look tough and get angry. It's time to intimidate the locals.
I'm not sure I can do it. How do you guys get angry?
Find the match deep inside yourself. Light it and let the fire burn up your guts and boil your blood.
Yeah, I pretty much do the same thing. Look, our goal is to drive away these miners, and we'll do whatever it takes. Listen up, dirtbags. Time to clear out. From now on, this bar is Cooper Gang turf.
Tough talk, wagga. But you ain't got no respect with us. We here are known around these parts for our drinking skills. And this just happens to be a lemonade bar.
Sly, I'm not sure this is such a good idea.
If a lemonade drinking challenge is what you had in mind, then the three of us will take on the best three lemonade drinkers you've got.
Fair dinkum. Losers have to clear out.
Ready, steady, go!
Suck it down!
Woohoo! Yes! Chug, oh, look!
Waterfall!
Wait, I'm allergic to lemons.
Steady on.
Gonzo, bugger!
Doubt it, sissy.
Buzzer!
Full on.
Savor the flavor.
Bring it down.
Remember to breathe.
Stomach, you jump back.
Swallow faster, man!
We win.
That's cheating. Why, the turtle spilled more than he drank. Round here, there's only one thing we do with cheaters. Turn on the fence, Bruce. It's time we gave these cheaters a beating.
Oops.
tense! Sly, you okay?
Right as rain, pal.
Good one, Sly! Sly, you okay?
Right as rain, pal. Just keep coming. You holding up, Murray?
Feeling strong. Behold my powers of destruction.
Thank you.
Give it to him, pal.
Hit, Murray!
Nice work, big guy. Looking good, Murray.
Champions!
Those guys won't be coming back here anytime soon.
Guys, looks like they saved their big guy for last.
He's wearing that freaky bad spirit mask. He must be so jacked!
We should work together to take this guy down. That mask has a powerful force in it.
Oh. Pinza Drogo Mazadox!
Lean him over my bomb and I'll pull the trigger! Hit him while he's dazed!
I'll try to knock him out with this bear!
Ready! Position!
I'm packing, Sly!
Finally, that guy was the mask. It's getting away?
We might have cleared out this bar, but that mask is sure to keep making trouble for us. We need to destroy it!
Oh,
You ready to head out for the oil fields? Should be right through this cave.
Oh yeah! Bentley said there'd be heavy machinery and destruction going down!
Sounds like your thing.
Y-E-S, yeah!
We're going after some radioactive oil, right?
I don't know. I can never pay attention during those slideshows. Don't tell Bentley.
Wouldn't dream of it.
While Murray gets all six oil wells flowing. Use this Super Claw 10,000 to deal with any miners that might show up. Use the left analog stick to move the claw around. The X button will pick up and release items. Before you're spotted, why don't you pick up that rock and drop it in the pit?
This is easy.
You do seem quite adept. The other important feature on the 10,000 model is the throwing action. Just pick up an item and press the circle button to throw them. You could throw things quite a ways. Go ahead and hit that electric fence with one of those rocks.
I think I've got the hang of it.
Nice shot. Let's see you do it again.
Face it, Bentley. I'm a natural.
Hope you're right, because it looks like the miners are onto us. Defend the power stations by using everything and anything in the oil field. This electric fence should come in especially handy for dispatching guards. Here they come.
Hey, deadly fence, miner guy! I got one well flowing. Two more to go. Stop! Give him the fit!
Should draw the deep uranium-enriched glowing oil to the surface. We'll need to be extremely careful in retrieving a small sample.
Fly! Fly! Look at me! I'm glowing! Woo!
You can feel it in the air. The miners are about to pack it in. In fact, they'd probably already be long gone if it weren't for the corrupting influence of the Mask of Dark Earth. It's clear we need to destroy it. Time for Operation Moon Crash. To start things off, we'll need the Guru to take out the gyrocopter. With it gone, we'll have clear skies for Phase 2. Now, according to Aboriginal folklore, the Mask of Dark Earth is the sworn enemy of the Moon Spirit. So, given Murray's moon shape, we'll coat him in the glowing oil and have him pose as the Spirit. We'll then dangle him from the crane. The Mask is sure to spot his ancient foe and come running. That's when we'll strike. Murray, thunderclap off the crane and obliterate that mask. With the mask destroyed and the miners run off, The Guru will be free to join the team for the Cooper Vault job.
Join the team, but we need your help to destroy the Mask of Dark Earth.
Hi, Yahoo.
Your objective is to take out the gyrocopter while it's refueling. Glad to hear you're up to it. The bad news is the gyrocopter has a sensor that can detect your moonstone. I suspect that's how they found and trapped you earlier. Get too close, and they'll detect you, then take off out of reach. For this job, you'll need to run guards toward it, and then jump off early before it senses you. Ram a few guards into that thing, and it's sure to fall apart.
Behold! The moon spirit rises! Woo!
Everyone keep an eye out for the mask. It's sure to take the bait.
We got a situation here, fellas. Looks like Carmelita finally managed to catch up.
Drat! We can't stop the operation now. We'll just have to give her a wide berth.
Roger, applying wide berth.
Quit horsing around and look out for the mask! It's close! I can feel it!
Haida! Whoever!
Here I come, Master!
Did you get it? Is the mask gone? Sly, can you see?
Can't tell from here. I'll move in.
Thought I'd find you here.
Carmelita, you've got a little something on your face.
It's not nice to make fun of a girl's looks.
Maybe I should smell.
Now, that's not nice.
Bentley, could use a little help. How about putting a few of your sleep darts in Karmalarja here? They will pry off the mask.
Finally, the darts are starting to kick in. Or not. The chemicals in my darts must somehow be interacting with the mask to make her even bigger.
Whoa, you're not kidding, Bentley. She's getting gigantic. Everyone head for the big truck. We've got to get some distance between her and us. She might shrink back down with time.
In the truck.
How do you do that?
This is bad. We need a new strategy, and fast. Force just isn't working.
Time to stop running and deal with the real problem. Pry off that mask of Dark Earth, and maybe we'll get back the Karmalita we all know and love.
I do not love her.
Okay, not the point. It's all about taking off that mask. We gotta find a way up there.
You're the climber, and I'm sure you've always wanted to get closer to her. Can't get much closer than climbing up her bootlaces.
That's not a crazy idea.
Oh yeah, it's crazy.
You got a better idea?
Yeah, but we'd need a giant fighting robot.
Sorry, I'm gonna have to go with the bootlace plan.
and look! Looks like each side of the mask is latched on with only one hook! Maybe if you hug off it, she'd swat you away and knock it off!
Carmelita just lay there, unconscious, helpless on the desert floor. Being gentlemen, we kept watch over her throughout the night. Her camera proved to be a real source of entertainment as we took turns posing. Didn't want her to go home empty-handed. Morning broke, and we got a clear view of the landscape. It was beautiful, empty of the miners that had been digging and drilling into the sacred place. The moment was broken as Carmelita began to stir, and we prepared for another quick exit. Only this time, it wasn't just the three of us. For the first time in Cooper Gang history, we picked up a new member, and the team would never be the same.